Anybody who visited his neighborhood came in with absolutely no preconceived notions of what they wanted or what their motivations were. It was just like, oh, how nice to see you.
It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine?
What's your first recollection of Mr. Rogers, for you personally?
You know, I grew up watching Mr. Rogers, but the thing about it is it's so, such early memories. It's almost like in your DNA more than in your conscious memory. What happens is you go back and you see the stoplight and your heart leaps into your throat, you know, suddenly you're brought back to these memories.
We are trying to give the world positive ways of dealing with their feelings.
There's a lead bird in the flock, and it was not nature, and it was not any act. It was really Mari. It was Mari laying down what the philosophy of the movie was going to be.
You could play all the lowest keys on a piano at the same time.
Where'd you guys primarily shoot?
We shot in Pittsburgh. We shot in Pittsburgh where Mr. Rogers originally lived. We filmed the neighborhood in the original WQED studios where he filmed. We had people who worked on the original show working on our movie, cameramen and people who worked in the art department.
Could anyone else have played the role of Mr. Rogers other than Tom Hanks? Because you can't just rely on one person when you're casting.
No. It's at this point, now that the story has such a happy ending, I can't imagine anyone else playing Mr. Rogers. But the truth is, the way we feel about Tom Hanks is so similar to how we feel about Mr. Rogers. There's so few people who...
It's close. It's very close. It's, yeah. It's eerily close.
It's different, but it's different, got a similar warmth.
I think the best thing we can do is to let people know, boom, that each one of them is precious.
Shawn Edwards, Fox 4 News.